that's what is required when you have an idea. You have to say, you know what, I'm going to master this thing.
Right.
I'm not going to practice on people and try to charge them top dollar. You know what I mean?
Right.
That's not how this is going to go. God will not get the glory for it. I have to be able to master a thing. And that means doing it not until you get it right. That means doing it until you can't get it wrong.
Thank you.
Okay, so we landed. We're here in Richmond, Virginia. Super excited. Just getting in the car so we can show them.
Speaking of wealth, this book right here says brand to bucks. Let's talk about it. Our next guest, glory be to God, is none other than Coleen Otero. Would you help us welcome the CEO chick? How did you get started? How did you get started?
So
how
was
your entrepreneurial beginnings?
Oh, entrepreneurship, yes. Or CEO chick. But entrepreneurship began for me at the age of 12 years old. We had hair problems in my home. My mother was not good at doing hair. And I just all of a sudden got tired of being made fun of. You know, it was the press comb days and getting your hair straightened and it was not the best. And you come home and the texture would change and so on and so forth. And so problems produce products and services.
Problems produce products and services.
Mm. And right there at the age of 12, I began doing my hair and getting compliments from adults. And I remember the day I did my mother's hair for the first time. Thank you, mommy, by the way, who's watching. You know what she did? She put money in my hand the first time I did her hair. And right then and there, I didn't know it, but she was honoring the gift that was in me. And she was letting me know that it was worthy of a transaction. And so as soon as I graduated high school, I went right into the beauty industry. And as a result of that, so many doors opened. I didn't have an agent. I didn't go the route a lot of people do. However, with technology and social media and the changes that it made, I had more people reaching out to me, celebrities, you know, using social media, who's in the city, people saying my name. And so I had the opportunity to work with individuals working on Bravo and talent from The Voice and women of God doing great things, commissioners, so on and so forth. And it's just been a blessing.
So, on my plane, getting ready to leave Richmond, Virginia to head home to Orlando. And just honestly in awe of God right now and just grateful. You know, the way I could describe it, just grateful. You never know who is listening or why we go through the things we go through, and just have to share that, you know, with. It's just amazing to me how our story and sometimes the painful things we go through once we get out on the other side, it's like helping someone else, giving hope to someone else. Just always been amazed by that. That the things that we hated the most are the things that turn around and reward you.
Meet Patty.
Amazing. I'm gonna take a nap. So
what did one ocean say in the other?